Hi everyone, Yasmasonia. Thank you very much for watching. Today I'm going to talk to you about how we together can make South Africa amazing. South Africa is facing a lot of issues currently, but so do the rest of the world. South Africa is currently having a lot of issues, but so does the rest of the world. We were just very conscious about what's happening in South Africa because we actually stay here. Every country do have the issues in their in unique way. So allow me four ideas today to potentially change your perspective about life and South Africa. Number one is focus on new reality. We tend to see the world not as it is, but as we are. And we see the world through the filters of our eyes that's been influenced subconsciously by the community, social media, propaganda, how we grew up. But the reality is the outer world and how we see the world will always be influenced by our inner self. And whatever we do inside will always reflect on the results that we receive on the outside. So the way we see South Africa might be just be how we've been subconsciously influenced by propaganda and the news and the community around us, the people we talk to. So I want to challenge you for the next 3 days. Fast from social media, fast from any news, fast from negative talk sayers, far from the toxic people in your life, and really just focus on developing yourself. Rather take a book and develop yourself on a specific subject. Journal about your ideas. In the next 3 days, you will have a lot of extra time when you start fasting on all these things. So you will have a lot of time. Journal on your new ideas that you may have. Journal about your thoughts and become very conscious about everything that you surround yourself with. Number two is be the change. Be the kindest person that you know. My latest thing that I do is I do a little fist bump to each and every person that I meet. It's amazing how you change somebody's attitude just by being kind. Just do a little fist bump from nowhere for somebody, like a waiter or a parking attendant or a person at the garage that need to refuel your car. Just open your window, smile and be kind. Just ask them how they are today. Put out your hand and do the little fist bump and just spread that kindness. It's one little thing that you can do can change somebody else's life today. And if we spread this kindness in South Africa, we will make this South Africa amazing. Number three is every thought, every word and every action. I become very aware about every thought, every word and every action that I do, because I realized that everything I do consciously influences my subconscious mind, and my subconscious mind in time becomes my reality. In the end, we attract what we become. So for me to be better and to receive better and to influence better, I need to change those three things. So become very, very conscious about every thought that you think, every word that you speak, and every action that you do. And number four, don't be afraid of the darkness of the economy. The world is currently going through a recession, but there will always be a recession, and there will always be an expansion period. There will always be a summer, and there will always be a winter. In life, in business, in the economy, we can't change that, but we can change our perspective, how we see the summer and the winter. In my opinion, winter is the best season to create new opportunities and to fine-tune your business. In the summer season, you've never looked at the things in your business that either need to be taken away or need to be fine-tuned. And the winter season assists us to actually sit back and reflect on everything that we need to look at in our business. I hope these four ideas will change your perspective or just give you some insight or just remind us about how we can change the world and specifically for us, how we can make South Africa amazing. Hi everyone, Yasmason here. Today is volume 2 of Together We Can Make South Africa Amazing. Point number 1 is generosity. Become massively generous. It doesn't have just to be monetary. In fact, it can be spreading massive amounts of kindness. It can be spreading a lot of value to your client base. I'm into entrepreneurship. Spread massive value to entrepreneurs. It can also be monetary, and you can pick your course of choice.
But keep being generous. We can't choke the generosity or the flow of money on the one side and expect abundance on the other side. It's an energy flow, and we need to keep it coming and keep it flowing on the one side to receive abundance on the other side. So if you haven't been generous as yet, start small, but start today. The more kindness and the more generosity we spread in South Africa, the more South Africa will be amazing. Number two is ego is the enemy. I'm into martial arts, and every time I would go into a sparring session or learning technique with my ego, I step out of the class without any benefits. Letting go of my ego provide me the opportunity to learn in fast pace and provide me to be open to new ideas and new opportunities as an entrepreneur. Let's stop trying to run a country with our heads and with our mind, and let's start running a country from inside here, from our heart. And once we realize that we don't need to run a country with our heads and with our minds, we will see a difference in Africa, and we will make Africa amazing. Number three is start supporting local businesses. Many years ago, I started supporting local businesses whenever we travel. Whenever we go on a week or two vacation, I would rather buy all my purchases and all my goods I need for the vacation in that specific town. I love to, just by general rule, love to support local businesses wherever I come to, every small town that I get to, and like to visit restaurants of that town, support them, visit them, and tip the waiters amazingly. On that note, I've created the gift bag for entrepreneurs to the value of 57,000 rand, and it's available for free to every entrepreneur in South Africa. Click on the link below and you will access the link to the free gift bag for entrepreneurs. I've started the gift bag for two reasons. Firstly, for local small business owners to start supporting each other, because I feel it's never been so important for small business owners in South Africa to support each other. Secondly, I provide a platform for entrepreneurs to offer their services to other small business owners in South Africa. So get your link in the description below, and you will have access to all the various vouchers of the value of 57,000 rand. And number four, don't be stuck in old ways. There's a saying that says, don't push a boulder uphill just because you can. In a new fast economy, make a consistent effort of evaluating your business every week, every month, every quarter, if you are still heading the correct way. It's not to say that if a business was working a year ago, 5 years ago, 10 years ago, it might still be working today. The economy is changing so much, and we're in an information era, and some of the business that used to work is not relevant anymore. So on a consistent basis, make sure you evaluate your business and make sure you're still relevant in today's economy. Thank you very much for watching, and let's make South Africa amazing together. Today is volume 3 of Together We Can Make South Africa Amazing. During the past weeks, I gave you 2 volumes or episodes to suggest how we as entrepreneurs can make South Africa amazing again. And today, once again, is volume 3, and I will give you 4 more ideas of what I believe how we as entrepreneurs can make this country amazing again. Number 1 is extreme customer service. Customer service is probably one of the most important aspects of your business. By giving good customer service and massive value to your clients, you can keep their loyalty with your business. I recently saw a picture of one of our monthly accounting clients, where obviously they visit Cattle Baron Paul a lot, and Cattle Baron Paul actually decided to make them both, the husband and the wife, a steak knife with all their names engraved on that steak knife. A beautiful gesture of to give back to a loyal customer that's been supporting you forever. This client of ours will probably tell each and every client to visit Cattle Baron in Paul, because they gave such a great gesture of gratitude towards their client. You being an entrepreneur,
I know you also want to wow your customers. So reflect and sit back and actually think about a few ideas that you can give back to your customers that really make them feel special and keep them loyal to your business. Number two is start small, but start today. I know such a lot of people with such amazing talents, but they can't seem to take that first step towards the business idea. I want to encourage you today, take that first step and go towards your goal and your dreams that you want to live. Maybe that ikigai of yours is really just one step away from opening up and become a reality. I will encourage you today, take that first step. Take that first step towards your business. Every step you take from there will become easier. It's only the first step that keeps you away from running your potential, being the most amazing person that you know. Run into that fear, because when you run into your fear will always run away. So take that first step today. Start small, but start today. Number three is the Pareto Law. About 2.5 years ago, I went up a mountain with a very good friend of mine, and he told me about a friend of his that applied the Pareto Law in his business constantly. And at that stage, I was really burnt out, and I was very open to his advice. And since then, I started using and applying the Pareto Law in my business, but also in my private life. The Pareto Law is much better known as the 80-20 rule, and it's really a valuation of where you are at your life and where you spend the most time with and where you get the most reward from. Applying this Pareto Law can be very daunting and very difficult in the beginning, because like in the words of Robin Sharma, everything is hard at first, it's messy in the middle, but it's gorgeous at the end. So when you start applying the Pareto Law, I received a lot of resentment from business associates, from friends that didn't like what I was doing because it didn't fit the picture of them in their life currently. But by using the Pareto Law, I made a list of everything toxic in my life, whether it was in business or in my personal life, and I took that out of my system. And by doing that, obviously it had a lot of pressure on me and on my business, because I took a lot of elements out of the business and the whole restructure of basically your whole life. But once you do that, and currently I'm doing that on a constant basis, even before I have a new business client or a new potential friend in my life, I would evaluate that person and make sure if that person fits into my picture of my Pareto Law in my life. Point number four is learn something new today. For things to change, we need to change. I always try to remember my inner child. By observing my children, I can see how I used to be so open for learning and being like a sponge. I would encourage you today to keep being open to new ideas. Be like a sponge. We all have been like that. We as children been like that. We grew up and society told us your dreams are too big, and told you whenever you wanted to try something new, told you no, you're stupid, or it can't be done. And this was really just society's mediocre opinions. Go back to your inner child. Remember what made you happy. Remember your big dreams that haven't come true because you listened to society and people around you. Start learning new things again. Start doing the things that really makes you happy. And the more we learn, we create new opportunities for ourselves, because we create better awareness for ourselves. And by creating better awareness for ourselves, we start making better decisions. And when we start making better decisions, we start creating a new reality and a better reality for ourselves. Thank you again for watching. Let's make South Africa amazing together. If you are Entrepreneurs Africa, remember to go into the link below in the description, and you will find a free gift bag for entrepreneurs to the value of 57,000 Rand. It's free of charge. You don't have to do anything. You can activate it and you can use all the entrepreneurs similar to you on that gift bag. I started this gift bag for two reasons. The one for South African entrepreneurs to start working together and support each other. And secondly, I gave a platform for entrepreneurs to showcase their businesses and give you a voucher to use in their specific business. All you need to do
is go in the description, click on the link, and activate your gift pack. If you found any value from this video, please remember to share this with a fellow entrepreneur friend. And please remember to subscribe to this YouTube channel. Thank you very much.